It is the Tokyo Aquatic Center for the final session in the final event at the diving pool for the Olympic Games Tokyo 2020. And what a final it is. It's the men's 10-meter platform final. It's the third session. In session one, we had 29. We whittled that down to 18 for session two, which was the semi-final. From 18, we've gone to 12, who will decide the medals. 12 athletes from 9 countries in the final of the 10-meter platform. It promises to be as engaging and entertaining as the entire program has been at the Tokyo Aquatic Center in the diving competitions. 7 gold medals already handed out for the 7 previous events in both synchro and individual events. 6 of those gold medals have gone to China, 1 to Great Britain. And it is once again the Chinese divers who come into this men's 10-meter platform final very much as the favourites.
Absolutely, and what a journey they've had to get here in the first place. It's taken a few years for all the qualifications since the World Championships. We then had the World Cup just about 3 months ago here in the Tokyo Aquatic Centre when the final ones qualified. They've then had to get through the preliminary rounds, then to the semi-finals, and finally, their dream of being in the finals is here. And now all they can hope is that it goes their way. None of the scores carry through from the semi-finals, so anybody could be up there with a chance of being on that podium.
And it'll all play out on that platform. 12 competitors in this final. They will make their way, as you can see, into the call area. They range in age and experience quite significantly. The youngest, the local young man, Tamari Rakuto, 14 years of age, all the way up to the experience of Viktor Minibayev of the Russian Olympic Committee, 30 years of age. Some have won Olympic medals, some have won world championships, some have been on the circuit for many years. Others have announced themselves on the world stage by making this Olympic final. You throw it all into the melting pot, and we will see who comes out with the medals.
And what we've always said is to make it through from the preliminaries to the semi-finals, what you need is consistency. Once you're in the final, you need consistency of really good diving to stand any chance at all of getting on that podium.
Absolutely. Consistency of excellence is now what's required. And we will meet the 12 men who have made it into the final. It's been a wonderful venue, a wonderful home. And for the final time, we go to the final 12. Juan Figueroa Pereira, 19 years old, squeezed into the final in a very tense semi-final. Goes first, but he's already surpassed his ranking and is in his first Olympic Games. Andres Isaac Villarreal Tudor of Mexico, 16th at the World Championships back in 2017. Little on the world stage since, but in any trouble he's had, he's provided a positive response. Brandon Losiavo of the United States, 24 years old, 8th at the World Championships in 2019. He's looked very solid in both the prelims and the semi-final. His compatriot, Jordan Windle, also of the United States, the 22-year-old from Austin, Texas, born in Cambodia, mentored by the double Olympic champion in both 84 and 88, Greg Louganis. Tamai Rakato of Japan, a remarkable performance from the 14-year-old to get to this final. It'll be interesting to see how he handles the pressure of an Olympic final. And from a 14-year-old to a 15-year-old, Alexei Sereda of Ukraine, 15, remarkable consistency in the semi-finals, has all the talent, no question about that. Cassia Russo of Australia, the 20-year-old, will go seventh. Clearly enjoyed the semi-final. Never looked anything other than a finalist throughout that competition. Viktor Minibayev of the Russian Olympic Committee started slowly in the semi-final, but warmed to his task. Has a third Olympics under his belt and has a bronze medal in the 10-meter synchro already. Tom Daley showed glimpses of his ability in the semi-final. He'll need consistency of excellence if he wants to double his goal tally at these games. Alexander Bondar of the Russian Olympic Committee also. He's regularly split the Chinese divers in the prelims and through the semi-finals. He's in superb form and already has a bronze to his name at these games. Yang Jian of China will go 11th along with his compatriot Cao Yuan. He's shown glimpses of vulnerability in this competition, but the current world champion has a proven track record on the big occasion. And Cao Yuan also has a proven track record on the big occasion. Four-time Olympic medalist, looking to become the first male diver to win gold medals at three separate diving disciplines. He has gold in the 3-meter individual, gold in the 10-meter synchro. He now looks for gold in the 10-meter platform individual.
What an incredible lineup it is. It's going to be a thrilling finals.
Well, we talked in the first session and in the second session about needing to start in and around the 65 to 70 mark and keep the scores consistently 65 to 70 if you wanted to have a reasonably smooth run from the 29 to the 18 and then through the semi-final to the final. It is going to need to be significantly better than that, and consistently so, to get among the medals. As you look at the judges and their role in this competition.
Yeah, it certainly does need to have excellence today if they are going to be up there. And these are the all-important judges that will make the decisions on whether that dive was perfect or not. They have milliseconds to make that decision because they don't get to see the slow-mo that we will be getting on your screens. But they have to look at the approach, the takeoff, the flight in the air, and that all-important entry. It's important to remember it's all parts of the dive that count. It's not all about the entry, but gosh, that entry is so important. And the timing of those spins, getting it absolutely perfect, spotting the water or the ceiling, depending on which way they're spinning, and then hitting that perfect vertical line as they enter the pool. That's what they're going to want to do.
There are, of course, as you've seen, seven judges, three of them over on the far side of the pool, as you will see it momentarily, four on the near side. The seven judges, well, their two top scores and the two bottom scores will be taken away from each dive. It will leave us with three scores. Those three scores are added together and then multiplied by the degree of difficulty. And the degree of difficulty, as Andrea will take you through as the competition unfolds, well, they will vary anywhere between 3.2, 3.3, all the way up to 4.1. And when we get to that sort of territory, when you get a high degree of difficulty and you deliver a dive of quality, well, it can improve your score and improve your positionings momentarily.
Completely. If they're doing a 3.2, it has to be executed perfectly to get a really high score. You can afford to be slightly off on the higher degrees, but not too much. And we've got a 4.1, which is going to be one of the last dives we see in this final, but that is going to hopefully be truly exceptional. Didn't quite come off in the semi-finals, but hopefully it will in the finals.
Well, such a physically demanding sport. Many don't quite see, but at the end of the semi-finals, the number of divers who were receiving attention for joints and shoulders and around the wrists and ankles from the pressure that's put on the body. It looked like something, a bit like an accident and emergency ward as we headed towards the final. But everybody is fully fit and ready to go. And what a final session we look forward to. The men's 10-meter platform final. The first to go is Kewan Figueiredo Pereira of Brazil. The medals at the Olympic Games at stake.
That balance on the end of the platform as they wait to take the first dive in this finals. Just slightly got the timing wrong with an over rotation there, but has done incredibly well to qualify for the finals, having finished 37th in the World Championships a couple of years ago.
Absolutely, from 37th to a guaranteed in the top 12. It is a 60.8 for the man who leads us on his way from Brazil. And now we go to the man from Mexico, Andreas Isaac Villarreal Tudon. And you will notice that this gentleman takes his time. Others approach the board and execute immediately, as quickly as they possibly can. Villarreal Tudon has taken his time and worked himself through it psychologically in each and every round, through the preliminaries and the semi-final.
A slight over-rotation on the inward 3.5 somersaults. Degree difficulty 3.2. This is really important that they move well away from the board, because they go inward towards it and would get penalties if they were to hit it. It was a good start from him, just didn't quite nail that entry.
67.
Started well in the semi-finals as well, finishing 8th in the first two dives, so needs to keep that going.
67.20 for him. Then we move on to Randall Lociavo of the United States of America, 24-year-old, 8th at the World Championships back in 2019. So not in unusual territory in making a world-class final.
Another one choosing to go with the inward as well. They have to choose dives from 5 different categories. This is really nice and tight on the tuck position, good extension in the feet, and good alignment into the water. You'll see a lot of them have chosen this inward dive to start it off. 67.20.
So from one American, we go directly to the second American in this final. Remember, diving in reverse order of their qualification from the semi-final. Jordan Windle, inward 3.5 somersaults for him as well, the 22-year-old.
Excellent diving from him. Finished second to Brandon, his teammate, at the Olympic trials. So their own little competition going on here, a bit of friendly rivalry, but a lovely start.
Yeah, a very solid start from him. 68.8 for the second of the Americans to go in the first round. Now, Tamai Urakuto will dive number 5 in this final. And it is a remarkable story for a 14-year-old to come to an Olympic Games, his first major World Games, his home Olympics. And he has shown composure, and he's also shown significant bottle. He was gone, we thought, in the preliminaries. Came up with a score of 91.8 to make it to the semi-final, and has got better from there.
A little bit of an over-rotation, but as you say, how incredible that he managed to actually qualify for this finals at 14 years of age. Tom Daley was similar age when he started competing and has told him he really needs to soak it all in. And I'm sure he is absolutely doing that and enjoying the experience of being in an Olympic Games final, 72.
72.00 puts him first of the five that have completed their first rounds. As we go to, well, from the 14-year-old to the 15-year-old, Oleski Sureda of Ukraine. Inward 3.5 somersaults for him as well. Difficulty of 3.2.
Beautiful start. Really lovely. Hardly a ripple came up there. He was the European champion back in 2019, the youngest ever. And after that, his family made the decision to move to Kiev. And he got a grant to go to special school so he could carry on his training, and Sister Maria was also given 50% off so that she could attend too. So getting plenty of support back in Ukraine.
83.2. He was so consistent in the semi-final, bar one dive. Had that been a more solid effort, he would have finished in the top four or five, but at 83.2 for him to start. Now we go to Cassiel Russo of Australia. Inward 3.5 somersaults for him as well. He was consistent in the semi-final.
And it's an incredible story. He only began diving 4 years ago. 4 years ago, and is now in an Olympic Games final. So he wasn't even diving when Rio happened. But he was an artistic gymnast and is well used to doing all of these somersaults and turns. But slightly over-rotated on that one.
Yeah, he'll be disappointed with that. He had a very good semi-final. And a 57.6 puts him at the bottom of the pile after the first seven have completed their first dives. Well within his compass to deliver dives in the 80s and get himself back into contention, but on the back foot from the beginning. Vitor Minibaev, inward 3.5 somersaults, difficulty of 3.2. Remember, the divers get to choose the rotation of their dives, whether they put these first, second, third, or fourth.
Beautiful start from him. Really nice and steady on his 3.2. Very experienced. The current world and European silver medalist.
68.8 for Minibaev to start his program. Puts him into third place as a roar goes up over on the far side from the supporters in attendance, all accredited through the Aquatic Centre for Tom Daley. Reverse 3.5 somersaults, the difficulty of 3.4. His first dive in the prelims, his first dive in the semi-final were not strong. He cannot afford to start badly here.
And that was so much better. Absolutely brilliant, 3.4. The coach absolutely loved that one. Lots of fist pumping. He has worked with Jane Figueredo since about 2013. And she has done some fabulous work with him as we hear all of these tens. What an incredible start from Tom Daley.
Yeah, tens on the board from a couple of judges. They will be discarded all bar one, but what a way to start for Tom Daley. There were questions about his consistency coming into it. 98.6. That is a fantastic start. Alexander Bondar of the Russian Olympic Committee. Inward 3.5 somersaults, difficulty of 3.2. He has been really strong the whole way through prelims and the semi-final.
Well, difficult to follow Tom Daley after he's got tens, but did a magnificent job. Really nice dive from him.
8.7. Yeah, not the tens of Daley, but a strong start from Bondar nonetheless. 75.2. Might be slightly disappointed having set the standards of consistent 80s in the semi-final. But 75.2 will have him very much in the upper half of the scores at the end of the first round. Already we're down to the final two divers of the first round. First to go of the two that remain is Yang Jian. Difficulty of 3.4 on this reverse 3.5 somersaults. Current world champion. First dive of 6 in this final.
Oh. It was good. It was very good. But Tom Daley, that we see there, he's really put them under pressure right from the word go, hasn't he? Getting those tens.
Lots of nines for Yang Jian. He will find himself about 8.5 points behind Tom Daley at the end of round one, 90.10.
And choosing to do the same dive as Daley.
So we go to Chao Yuan, who will complete the first round of diving in this final. ...26 years of age, 4 Olympic medals already to his name.
Fabulous start from him. Again, that reverse 3.5 somersaults. The 3.4 degree difficulty, just the three of them going for the 3.4, and it was a fabulous dive, and I'm sure you can hear all of those tens. What a start.
What a start. 102.00, the quality of diving in that first round. To think that you can score 83.2 and not be in the top three at the end of round one, well, that is at the highest level, and it has been delivered by the top three. 4-5 divers have really started with their very best, and it is, well, all the signals are for a terrific competition. Chao Yuan 102.00, Tom Daley 98.6, Yang Jian 90.1, Yung Sereda 83.2, Bondar at 75.2, and down we go. And already those in the high 60s and below are playing significant catch-up. But at the beginning of this, we wondered about Daley's ability to consistently deliver at the highest level for 6 dives in the final. He answered that question with the first dive. He now needs to build on that.
Yeah, he's been working such a lot on his well-being. I'm sure a lot of you've seen a lot of knitting going on, which keeps his head in the right place.
Back to the top we go, and it's the Brazilian who'll start us off in this second round, Juan Figueiredo Pereira.
That was a much better attempt than his first one. That will calm his nerves. Look at the strength off the board. Toes need to be pointed straight away. That was good. Good extension in the legs as well. Nice and steady diving.
Well, a 79.20, under normal circumstances, you would be saying that is going to catapult you up the leaderboard. But such is the quality already above him, and he started round two in 11th. He's got some work to do, but 79.2, unquestionably a good dive. Great score as we move to Andreas Isaac Villarreal Tudon. Down in 9th position after a 67.2 for his first dive.
Very nice and tight on the pike, but unfortunately got the timing wrong. As you watch here, it's very difficult. You can't spot the water on these back rotations. You have to spot the ceiling. And, well, the water came to a little bit early. He needed an extra 2 metres there, I think, to be able to get those legs into a straight line.
59.40. has a little look at his coach, has a little look at the video review that they all have access to as soon as they get out of the water, and we'll take those learnings into round three. So then, we move on to Brandon Lochavo. Arm stand, back two somersaults, 2.5 twists, getting into that arm stand, critical.
A little bit of an over rotation, which you could see at the end there, but fantastic, he's qualified for this finals. Just let the feet go a little bit loose there as well. He goes to Purdue University, that's where he trains, which is where David Bedaya, past Olympic champion, and Steele Johnson trained as well. He wants to follow in their footsteps, and they have inspired him all the way to be able to make this final.
Well, it's a disappointing score in the 50s, albeit the high 50s, 59.4 for the American, as his compatriot, Jordan Windle, makes his way to the end of the platform to set himself up for his second dive. Back 3.5 somersaults, a difficulty of 3.3.
Well, the coaches seem to like it. Such an inspirational story behind Jordan. Born in Cambodia, his parents died when he was just 1 year of age. Had to go into an orphanage. Jerry Windle from America decided he wanted to adopt. He was a single man. The only place he could adopt was Cambodia. He adopted Jordan, took him back to the US, and here he is competing for the USA at the Olympic Games. Truly sensational.
Remarkable story indeed. So then, from Jordan Windle to Tamai Rikuto, back 3.5 somersaults in the pike position, a difficulty of 3.6. Big test for the young man. Remember, just 14 years of age.
I really like the position he got into on the pike. Unfortunately, if we get a chance to see it again, you'll see that his hips twist just at the end, which will affect the judges' scores slightly, but not too much. Amazing diving for a 14-year-old. He became Japan's youngest national champion at just 12 and has won the hearts of a nation.
And his coach has been on an emotional roller coaster with him the whole way through the three sessions to date. 86.4 for Tamai. And then we go to the other young man in this final, Oleski Sereda of Ukraine. Back 3.5 somersaults for him. Difficulty of 3.3. He's in the tuck position.
Oh, 15 years of age last Christmas, and the officials in the Ukrainian team have said that they haven't set him any targets at all for Tokyo. They feel he's too young for that, want him to enjoy it. But what amazing diving we're seeing from him.
No targets. Well, here he is in an Olympic final, and right now inside the top five, 79.20 for both Sereda and Tamai, the 14 and 15-year-old, particularly in the men's side of the events. They are setting out their stall for 2-3 Olympics into the future. Remarkable talent. Cassio Russo of Australia. A really disappointing opening dive for him by his own high standards of the semi-final.
Yeah, that's it's quite hard to pull yourself up. AD Hinchcliffe there, giving him plenty of support. It's very hard to pull yourself up when you know you didn't do terribly well on the first dive. But he's in an Olympic final, and following in the footsteps of his grandfather, Michel Rousseau, who competed in track cycling for France, actually won a gold back in 1956 in Melbourne.
Well, the current Rousseau at the Olympic Games has managed a 61.2 in his second dive of this final. And now it's the turn of the first of the two from the Russian Olympic Committee, Viktor Minibaev. Reverse 3.5 somersaults for him. Starting from 7th after round one.
Beautiful. That's going to really help. Really nice off the board. Very tight on the tuck. Toes pointed. Spots the water. Just at the right time.
Yeah, lots of nines in the score. 91.8 will be the cumulative total of the judges and then the degree of difficulty in. That's really strong for him. And now to Tom Daley. 98.6 in dive one. Inward 3.5 somersaults. Difficulty of 3.2 is his second dive.
Oh, what a start. In his actual words, he said he made a real dog's dinner of the semi-finals. But gosh, he has come out here and he's excelling on his first two dives. What a start.
Oh, he's brought his A game. He has brought his A game. 91.2 for Tom Daley in his second dive.
We'll be getting so much support at home from Mum, Debbie, husband Lance and son Robbie. All going well so far.
Now to Alexander Bondar. Reverse 3.5 somersaults, a difficulty of 3.4 for the Russian. Born in the Ukraine.
Oh, the standard here is absolutely incredible. As you say, born in Ukraine, competed for Ukraine at the Olympic Games back in 2012, but then met his Russian girlfriend, moved to Russia. They're now married and he's taken citizenship, and that was exceptional diving from him.
It was better than Daley, 91.8. Tom Daley's 91.2 before that. So he has closed the gap slightly after two rounds, but only slightly, as we move on to the final two divers in the second round, who are, of course, the Chinese, and we begin with Yang Jian, inward 3.5 somersaults, difficulty of 3.5.
Amazing balance on the end of the board before he started. Really controlled that well. Stunning. Had to flatten his feet a little bit to make sure he didn't touch the board.
94.
Very slightly twisted.
94.5. The last four dives we've seen have been a 91.2, a 91.8, a 94.5. The standard is beyond anything we've seen in any other event so far in the diving, and there has been some outstanding diving in this Olympics to date.
And it's still only round two.
Absolutely, and there's a long way to go. Xiao Yuan will go next. He started with a score of 102. Inward 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position, a difficulty of 3.2.
Those entries are incredible, aren't they? He slightly went over. We're being very picky here, but it wasn't that lovely ripped entry we're so used to seeing from him. It was still very good, though.
It sure was. It's an 81.6. And, well, the three in the medal positions at the moment are separated from first to third by 6.2 points. That's an 81.6 from Xiao Yuan. But he doesn't lead, nor does his compatriot Yang Jian. After two rounds, it's Tom Daley, 189.8, 184.6 from Yang Jian, and 183.6 from Xiao Yuan. Then we move into the 160s for the next three that come, and below that, well, the gap is already so significant, it will take a dramatic fall in standards from those in the top half of the competition so far to be replaced by those in the bottom half.
Yeah, and when we were commentating in the preliminary rounds, Tom Daley wasn't doing so well. We said he needed to start knitting something together. He has absolutely done that so far in this final. Still four dives to go.
It's worth saying for all of the divers at the top, indeed anyone involved in this final, we have seen through the complexity of the dives that must be delivered and the slightest variance or mismanagement of one component part, and all of a sudden 90s can become 40s very, very quickly. To do it over six rounds at that level is an enormous ask. It's the Brazilian K1 Figueiredo Pereira who gets us underway in round three.
Yeah, and that wasn't quite as good as his second dive. And you can hear that from the scores here. Very difficult to spot that roof and get the timing right. Legs flipped over, front of the legs, hitting that water quite hard. Remember, they are going at about 35 miles an hour, so they can really feel it if their legs go in at that angle.
46.2 for the Brazilian who, along with his coach, have been so positive. Good, bad, or otherwise in the dives all the way through the competition so far. They've taken it at an emotionally standard level, never overly happy or overly disappointed, and have managed their way through to this final as we move to Andreas Isaac Villarreal Tudon. Armstand back three somersaults, difficulty of 3.5. Down in 10th position after round two.
So important to get the hands right on the end of the board there and hold that beautiful line. The arm stand was good. There wasn't too much fidgeting, and the judges are looking at that again as well. Slight movement of his toes, needed to bend his feet back to get them past the board, and then slight misjudgment on the timing.
A 59.50.
But his aim for Tokyo is to get into the finals, so he has achieved what he came out to do.
Yeah, all the divers, including those that have already left this competition, will have come with their own individual goals and a measurement of success. What you can say definitively is getting into this final is success for most, maybe those at the very top expecting medals.
Really pushed himself well away from the board there. I felt maybe he was trying just a little bit too hard. He really, really got a lot of power. But that tight pike was good. But again, that timing wasn't quite right. The way he approaches any of his diving competitions is he thinks of them as individual rounds and individual competitions in their own right. So he now needs to go away, regroup, forget that, and think about the next dive that he's got coming up.
Danilo Schiavo with a 48.6. It is the other man from the United States who will go next, Jordan Windle. Eighth position after two rounds, arm stand forward, three somersaults, a difficulty of 3.3.
Showed real strength the way he got into that arm stand. I felt though he wasn't comfortable just as he came off the platform. He's leant over quite a long way. And that timing, spotting the water and opening out just a little bit late, so didn't allow himself time to get into that vertical line. Started at 7 years old. Somebody spotted him at a summer camp and said he should take up diving, but 39.60, not what he would have wanted for that dive.
Temai Rikuto, forward 4.5, somersaults, a difficulty of 3.7 on this dive for the young Japanese.
Brilliant, so impressed with this young man. Unbelievable, 14 years of age. His hero is Terauchi Ken, who has inspired many, many divers over the years, the 41-year-old diver also competing here in Tokyo.
It's a 75.85, and if you listen closely the next time he dives, listen for the clicking of shutters as the cameras all around, and there are many, many photographers here, capture the images of that young man because he's captured the imagination of many in Tokyo and beyond. As indeed has this young man from the Ukraine. Alexi Serena, next to go in fifth position after the first two rounds of dives, another going to the arm stand. From there, it'll be back two somersaults, 2.5 twists, a difficulty of 3.6. The strength.
Yeah, really held that well when he brought his head forward. Absolutely a perfect line. He has upped the degree difficulty of his program. Up until the Olympic Games, his maximum was normally a 3.3, but it's gone with a 3.4, and that's 3.6.
15 years of age, he has an 83.2, a 79.2, and now he tags on an 88.2 in the final of an Olympic Games. Kessiel Rousseau of Australia next to go.
This was his best dive in the semi-finals. Got 84.15 there. Let's see if he can do that again.
Could really do with it down in 12th position after two rounds.
Well, certainly better than the last few dives. The coaching team in Australia have 16 Olympic Games between them. He's in really good hands from a coaching point of view.
And it's a far better score in this third round. Started with a 57.6, then a 61.2. Consistently better, 74.25 for the third round. But somewhat adrift of the huge scoring at the top of the leaderboard. Vitor Minibayev. Arm stand for him as well to get us underway. Down in sixth position after the second round. Managed a 91.8 in the last round after a reasonably average start.
Lovely diving. You can see the slight adjustment on the feet as he was holding that arm stand, but he held it beautifully. And it's important that they wait until they feel perfectly comfortable and ready to go. But really good diving from Victor Minibayev.
And really good scoring. Another 91.8 to follow the one he had in round two. The 68.8 in the first round. The only thing that separates him from the three or four at the very top. But he will improve his position again at the end of this third round. Now, Tom Daley.
This is the one in semi-finals that he only scored 54 for.
Forward 3.5 somersaults with one twist.
Much better. better attempt than in the semis. And he is really holding his own there. And the coach is absolutely loving it so far. Beautiful in the pike. Feet just slightly coming apart on that entry.
A third dive in the 90s for Tom Daley. It was a 98.6 to start, a 91.2 in the second round. It's a 91.8 in the third round.
9.
Gold, remember, for Daley already in the 10-meter platform synchro along with Maddie Lee. You wonder how much confidence that gave him, how much freedom it gave him coming into this individual event. Alexander Bondar next to go. He also with a 91.8 in the last round.
Again, beautiful on the platform. Really took his time. Bent the arms, push off. Get as far away from the board so that you don't hit it. Slightly twisted on the hips.
That's an 85.75. He's lost about 4.5 marks to Daley in this round alone. Will likely be in fourth place at the end of the third round, which of course is the halfway mark in this 12-man competition. Number 11 to go. Yang Jian, the 27-year-old, current world champion, also third at the World Championships back in 2017. Arm stand, back three somersaults for him, a degree of difficulty of 3.5. Remember, Tom Daley with a 91.8 in this third round. And that is outstanding.
Yeah, lovely diving. For some reason, he swapped the order of a couple of his dives from semi-final to final. So this dive he did second in the semis. It's entirely up to them. They can even change the dives if they want to.
89.25. Daley gets another 1.5 on Yang Jian in this third round. 89.25 in behind Daley. He goes into second place with one diver to go. And of course it's Xiao Yuan, the 26-year-old. He readies himself at the end of the 10-meter platform. Back 3.5 somersaults, a difficulty of 3.6. If he executes, he will score very well.
And these were the dives that in the semi-finals, his last four dives, he was always placed in that first position. Very, very nice and compact on that pike position.
It's a 97.20. Almost 6 points he makes up on Tom Daley in that third round. But Daley will still lead it at the halfway point. The three at the top have opened up a sizable gap from Great Britain, Tom Daley, from China, Xiao Yuan, from China as well, Yang Jian. Of course, much can happen, but right now, they occupy the medal positions. They are diving at the highest level and executing the highest caliber scores. And there you see it, Tom Daley, 281.6 from Xiao Yuan, 280.8. And Yang Jian at 273.85, a good 20 points back then to Bondar in fourth place. But we've seen 20 points made up by one magnificent dive and one where it's just slightly out of kilter and it can all change.
And this is where sports psychology is so, so important. The final three dives in the 10-meter platform, it's all so close. It's the ones that can control the nerves and go out there and dive their very, very best that will stay on that podium.
And we're talking about three athletes with vast experience, world champions, Olympic medalists, 2 and 3 Olympics under their belts in the case of Chua Yuan and Tom Daley. They'll all have to dig deep into that reservoir of experience now to control the emotions and execute, as will all others, as we're back to the Brazilian Figueiredo Pereira to get us underway in the fourth round.
Yeah, much better diving from him. And as we said, what an achievement for him to make the top 12 at this Olympic Games, having been 37th in the World Championships just a couple of years ago.
That's a 79.55 for the Brazilian, which is his best dive of the competition so far. Best scoring dive, 79.55. That is very good indeed. Andres Villarreal Tudon, the Mexican. That camera angle gives a wonderful sense of what the divers see when they look down from the edge of that 10-meter platform.
Took his time off the board. He tends to do that, makes sure that he's very composed for the pushing off from the platform. Nicely out of the tuck, but spotted the ceiling at the wrong time and needed to kick the legs up just a little bit later to hit that vertical.
42.50 for Tudon. Drops him down the order at the top of the leaderboard still. Of course, Daley, Chao Yuan, Yang Jian. As we move on to Brandon Lociavo, his third dive is a reverse 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position, difficulty of 3.4.
Well, the coaches seem to like that one. I heard some cheers going up, but then all the coaches are always so supportive of their divers. Oh, quite a big difference, a bit of a mixed bag then on the scores from a 7 to a 5.5. Remember, the two highest and the two lowest, though, don't count.
Yeah, I rarely see a differential of that significance. It's happened a couple of times only in the entire diving program. 5.5s up to 7s, discard the top and the bottom, and you add them together and multiply by the degree of difficulty, gives you a 69.7, and that a decent recovery after a poor dive in the last round. Jordan Windle.
Lovely. His dad sent him a message before he started competing here in Tokyo, saying, remember what I taught you, always stay humble, stay safe, have fun, and most importantly, smile. I think he's concentrating too much at the moment to do the smiling, but hopefully he will be happy with his performance here and there'll be plenty of smiling afterwards.
Well, it's an 88.8, which is a fantastic score in his fourth dive, and it's, well, you can see the body language, there's a confidence, and there is a big smile, and why wouldn't there be with a dive like that in an Olympic final? 88.8, that is Windle giving a really strong account of himself in this final after the disappointment of the dive in round three. To recover like that tells you about the mental strength, because we have seen many divers after a poor dive, they just cannot recover their form. To the young man from Japan, Tamai Rikuto, listen to the clicks of the cameras.
Such composure for somebody so, so young. Absolutely incredible. And, well, how do you get to be such a good diver at such a young age? Totally brilliant.
86.40. Well, they have taken the raw talent and done something very special with the young man. And no doubt more to come with the next Summer Olympic Games, only 3 years away. 86.4. Another man who will undoubtedly be at the Games in 3 years' time is Alexi Sereda.
Not one of his better entries. You could see the amount of water that was brought up, which is a shame because he's really been nailing them up until now. That will have an impact on those scores. Wants to add the forward 4.5 somersaults tucked to his list. It's considered to be just a little bit too difficult at 3.7, but I'm sure in Paris in 3 years' time, that's the dive we will see from him.
The first slip from the young man, the Ukrainian, 56.10. After an 83, a 79 and an 88, that will drop him down the leaderboard. Cassio Russo of Australia, the Brisbane man, just 20 years of age.
That was a much better dive from him. Getting his head into the right place. As I say, he's only been diving since 2017. But as a family involved in gymnastics, brother and sister Liam and Elodie, they compete in acrobatic gymnastics, and he has been in artistic gymnastics in a world championships and world games, and now here diving at the Olympic Games.
Sort of face that says, okay, I'll take that, 76.5. Better than where I was earlier on. Vitor Minibayev is next to go. 91.8 in rounds 3 and 2. Started with a 68.8. He's been there and done it before.
Been there, done it before, needs to add Tokyo 2020 to that tattoo. Lovely extension in the knees, right through to the toes. That's very nice. Didn't quite nail that entry though.
No, 73.8. Almost 20 points down on where he was in rounds 2 and 3. Now, the leader of the competition after 3 rounds from Great Britain, Tom Daley. With what's happening around him, I think it's fair to say that only excellence is good enough right now.
Well, it was very good. When he was just 11 years of age, he drew a picture of him doing a handstand on the 10-meter platform. That was 7 years before the London 2012 Games. But even then, he said he wants to go to the Olympics and win a gold medal, and he will continue to go to the Olympics until he does. His dream has already come true in the synchro, but he would love to do it in the individual too.
80.50 for Tom Daley. Under any other circumstances, you'd say that's a really solid, if not good, dive. But when you have divers of the ability around you, of the next to go in Bondar and also Xiao Yuan and Yang Jian, well, 80.50. We will see where that leaves him at the end of round 4. Bondar goes next.
Well, it was another good dive from Bondar. Arms holding those legs in tight.
Only judged 0.5 better than Tom Daley, 81.00. needed a bit better than that to close the gap up on the top three and challenge for a medal. Still within his grasp, but just two dives left to go. Yang Jian is next to go. Difficulty of 3.8 on this dive.
Yep, choosing to go with some really difficult dives for the forward 2.5 somersaults, 3 twists. This will really help his score. Remember, the 3 scores are added together and times by that degree difficulty of 3.8.
And it's a dive in the 90s for Yang Jian, 91.20. And it lifts him above Tom Daley. Almost 3 points fully ahead of Daley now at the end of round 4. Still very, very tight. One diver left to come at the end of this fourth round of dives, and it's the 26-year-old, twice male diver of the year, Cao Yuan.
Lovely alignment, and what I really liked about that dive was he kept his heels together throughout. That's very difficult to do. That dive was superb.
It's nines all the way across the board, and when you add that together and multiply in the degree of difficulty, you get a score of 97.2. And it is now Cao Yuan who will leads the way into round 5. Change at the top of the leaderboard. Tom Daley goes from, well, brilliance to excellence and drops from first to third. Confirmation of the 97.2. And now we will get confirmation of the top three and beyond in this competition after 4 rounds. 378.00 for Cao Yuan, 365.05 for Yang Jian, and 362.1 for Tom Daley. And they are again established in a lead, almost 30 points from Daley back to Bondar. And I'm afraid for the rest, it is about the minor placings, unless the top 3 or 4 have significant failure collectively as well as individually. So to round 5 for the 12 divers in the final of the men's 10 meter platform. It has been a thoroughly absorbing, engaging and high class final to this point. Figueredo Pereira is the man who gets us underway.
Just slightly missing the timing to be able to get that ripped entry. 5.5, 6, 5.5, 5.5, 6. And you can see the impact that has on the water, and here the judges' scores. Came into diving because he always did flips and cartwheels after scoring at football. So if you're watching this and you like doing football and you like doing flips and cartwheels, maybe you should be giving diving a go as well.
56.1 for the Brazilian, who's led the way in terms of starting off each round. The diving order decided by the placings in the semi-final. Those who finished top of the board in the semi-final got the opportunity to go at the back end of this final field.
That was his most difficult dive, the forward 4.5 somersaults, degree difficulty of 3.7. He really threw himself off that platform, moved quite a long way from the board.
It was good enough for a 72.15 for Andrei Isaac Villarreal Tudon. We move on to Brandon Lociavo. Gives you a sense of where they start from, way up there on the 10-meter board.
Yep, nice dive. We get a chance to have a look at it again in the slow-mo. The arms really tight to the body on the twist, but just a little bit heavy on the entry. Wants to become a diving coach when he finishes competing, so lovely that he wants to give back and train others up.
66.6 for Brandon Lociavo, eighth at the World Championships in 2019. And in that sort of territory in this Olympic final, Jordan Windell is next to go.
Well, he's having a pretty good day here at the Olympic trials. He actually got some 10s and 9.5s to qualify to represent Team USA at this Olympic Games. And has made it through to the finals.
69.70 for second of the Americans, Jordan Windell. And as his dad requested, he's doing it with a smile on his face. So then, Temai Nakuto, reverse 3.5 somersaults, difficulty of 3.4.
Bit of an over rotation on that one. And if he gets a chance to look at the film that they've just taken of him afterwards, he will see that. And that sadly impacted on those judges' scores.
Well, how quickly it can turn. A 72, an 86.4, a 75.8, an 86.4. Remarkably consistent diving at the highest level for the 14-year-old. That, I'm afraid, and his coach knew it as soon as he hit the water. A 35.7, and he will drop down that leaderboard at the end of the fifth round. Was sixth. Aleski Sereda.
Wow, he's really got it back again. And I mean, the dive that he did before wasn't as strong on the entries as that one was. But in the semi-finals, he scored 25.5 for it. So he is really good at pulling back if he's a little bit disappointed on the previous dive. That was beautiful.
It's a 75.00 for Oleski Serera of Ukraine. His picture has been a face of concentration for almost a full three sessions. Completely in control of his emotions at 15 years of age in an Olympic final. Cassio Russo next to go. For Australia, down in ninth place at the end of four rounds.
Well, that dive there was the same as the one Matthew Mitchum did in Beijing when he took the gold for Australia and got the best scores ever, something like 123 at the time. Unbelievable.
Well, that is a 72.00 for the Australian. By the heights of the scoring in the other rounds, we haven't quite got there yet. 75.00, the best we have in round five. That coming from Sereda. Here is Viktor Minibayev, who has scored well times in his program, 291.8.
Really nice. Just let those feet come slightly over. Getting a lot of height off the board.
And it gives him the first dive in the 80s of the fifth round. It's at 83.25 for Vitor Minibaev. As we get next to the man currently in the bronze medal position, Tom Daley atop the board. His fifth round dive forward, 4.5 somersaults in the tuck position, the degree of difficulty 3.7.
Lovely. Everybody appreciating that dive as they sit in the hot tub, keep all their muscles warm. And some fabulous diving from Tom Daley.
He is back in the 90s again, 94.35 for Tom Daley. Well, there is a brotherhood amongst those divers, a sisterhood, obviously, from the female side. They understand the commitment, they understand the dedication, the sacrifice to get to the levels of being able to score 94s and 95s and 100s in Olympic finals. They've all made it to this Olympic final and they appreciate excellence when they see it. He is not out of the running by any means for a gold medal. Alexander Bondar of the Russian Olympic Committee next to go.
Yep, very steady diving, really nice. Very, very experienced. Current European champion. Timed that to perfection.
Well, it's at 94.35 for him as well. From his perspective, he would have been hoping for a little bit more to try and close that gap on Daley, who he sees as the bronze medal at the moment, and to try and close that gap, but it's exactly the same score, so the gap will be maintained between Daley and Bondar at the end of this fifth round. The question is, from what position will Daley be going into the sixth round? Because we now come to the final two dives of the fifth round, and we start with Yang Jian, the 27-year-old, the current world champion. Back 3.5 somersaults, degree of difficulty 3.6.
Another sensational dive, scored 91.80 in the semi-finals with this dive, and that was absolutely brilliant.
102.6. There are 10s that will be discarded, there are 9.5s that will be retained. Yang Jian, 102.6.
Certainly putting everybody under pressure with that dive.
Wow. Xiao Yuan, will he be able to come up with an answer with the final dive of round six? Daley, with a 94.35, will lose about 8 points on Yang Jian in this fifth round. What about this man, Xiao Yuan?
Beautiful. Absolutely brilliant, and I'm sure everybody watching would have appreciated that dive. The execution, so strong.
It's another 100-plus dive. Score 101.75 for Xiao Yuan. Well, Daley asked, what could they do with a dive of 94.35 for him in round five? Both of the Chinese divers answer with scores in excess of 100. It is spectacular to watch the ability of all three, and you include Bondar as well, all four, to deliver their very best in an Olympic final. It is a pleasure and a privilege to watch. And right now, it is very much advantage China at the end of five rounds.
But don't forget, in the final round, Yang Yan is going with a forward 4.5 somersaults in the pike position, degree difficulty 4.1, and he only scored 77.9 for that in the semi-final, so anything can still happen.
Oh, there's no doubt this is by no means done, but it is the Chinese Zhao Yuan who leads the way on 479.75, Yang Jian 467.65, Tom Daley 456.45, and then a gap of about 28 points to Alex Bonnar in fourth position. It has flown by at the Tokyo Aquatic Centre. We are already at the start of round six. It is the Brazilian Kwan Figueiredo Pereira who will get us underway. It's been absorbing.
And a lovely dive to finish with. What a day he's had qualifying for this Olympic final at his first Olympic Games. Lovely diving to finish off. Bit up and down over the six dives.
Yeah, but a nice way to finish it, as you say. 72.00. Started off in the second round with a dive of 79.20. But that is a job really well done by the 19-year-old who came into this Olympic final having finished 37th in the World Championships 2 years ago. From 37th, well, he will finish, by my calculations, around 10th or 11th in an Olympic Games. That is significant progress in 2 years. Andreas Isaac Villarreal Tudon of Mexico.
And a good one for him to finish with as well. Kept the legs really close together as we have a chance to watch it here. Arms close on the twist. And a lovely entry. Good vertical alignment.
Well, the score is always a little slower to come through in the final round. Adds a little bit of drama to it all. Most definitely 81.00. 81.00 for the man who is currently 12th of the 12 finalists. And that tells you the standard that this final has created. A fantastic final dive for Tudon from Mexico. And we now go to Brandon Lochiavo of the United States.
Well, he's had some consistent diving here in this Olympic finals, and I'm sure Mum and Dad, Laura and Steve, will be absolutely delighted that he qualified for this final. Slightly over-rotated there, as you could see, but still a fantastic achievement for him at his first Olympics.
It's another dive in the 70s to finish 72.15. A wave goodbye to his Olympic final. Well done to him. And finish in 10th or 11th position based on the scoring so far. We'll confirm that, of course, by the time we get to the end of all the divers in round six. Next to go, it's Jordan Windle of the United States to finish off his program. Back 2.5 somersaults, 2.5 twists. Degree of difficulty 3.6, a 22-year-old to finish.
Well, we've seen some exceptional diving from him. And that was good. Feet slightly came apart and then a bit heavy on the entry. But fantastic for him to qualify. Just missed out in 2012 and 2016. And now he can say that he is an Olympian.
He can say he's an Olympian who made the final of his event. The Tokyo 2020 Games, it's a 68.4 for him to finish, and he will finish ahead of Pereira and Lo Schiavo, and also Virel Touron, and a big smile. No doubt we will see him in 3 years' time when we get to France for the next Summer Games. Tamai Rikuto of Japan has performed so wonderfully at his home Olympics under real pressure, real scrutiny for the athletes in Japan representing their country in a home Olympics.
And all of those cameras going yet again. These are the photographs that they all wanted. Such an incredible diver. I've really enjoyed watching him. A real talent for the future. He'll only be 17 when we get to Paris in 3 years' time.
And we'll be describing him as a veteran, no doubt, at that point as he enters his second Olympics and having been in an Olympic final. 75.60. Well done, young man, well done. So then to Oleski Sereda of Ukraine. Came sixth, Sereda, in the synchro 10 meter with Oleg Serbin earlier on at the Olympic Games, but he is being a bright light in this final.
He really has had a fabulous day. Just one dive slightly dropped him back a little bit, but that was really nice. They always seem to come out here, pull out all the stops, legs slightly opening, didn't keep those heels together, but what a lovely entry. And here's another one that will only be 18 when we come to Paris.
Well, there's a finish, 80.00. Sereda finishes with a flourish. We've had six dives in the final round. The lowest score is a 68.4. Everything else has been above 70. Rousseau forward 4.5 somersaults, a degree of difficulty of 3.7 for him to finish.
And a beautiful one to finish. Andy Banks, Adrian Hinchcliffe, high fives all the way, and congratulations to all the coaches of Australian diving.
It just continues the standard through this final round of dives. Waiting for the score to come through, but, well, there you go. It's an 88.8.
And that shows what he's capable of. Yeah, brilliant way to finish.
And that's the sort of diving we saw from him in the semi-final in the second session. But as we've said so often, to have that consistency in the high 70s into the 80s, all the way through the prelims, the semi-final and the final, it is a monstrous ask. And in this final, well, he just didn't hit the standard from the beginning, but he sure as heck finished with an 88.80. Viktor Minibayev, his final dive of this program, started with a 68.8, but after that, well, 91.8, 91.8, he had an 83.2, and somehow it's all added up to have him in just fifth place.
Yep, lovely on the twists. Feet straight and together on the heels, legs extended. Would have liked to have seen maybe a slightly more compact pike, but a good dive to finish.
And in he comes, his score at an 86.4. Well, if you hoped to dive an 80s plus and close the gap and maybe jump up a couple of positions in the final round, you'll have been sorely disappointed, because the standard has just been so strong. A big hug and a congratulatory pat on the back for a man who finished with 86.4. Now then, Tom Daley, now then, your final effort in this men's 10-meter platform final into sixth round in third position.
Oh, and it was a really good one. He's been inspired by knowing that his son Robbie is watching him along with husband Lance, and he's come out here and given it everything today.
Well, it was a gold in the 10-meter synchro event with Matty Lee. He has come out in the final and been consistently excellent throughout. Started with a 98.6, then a 91.2, a 91.8, the slight blemish of an 80, blemish of an 80.5, and he has finished with a 91.8. And that is a fantastic set from the program of Tom Daley. Gives him a total of 548.25. And he will walk away with a medal, surely. The colour.
Lovely. Big hugs from his coach, Jane. They have worked so long together and so hard. Well done, Tom Daley.
Alexander Bondar, who came into this final as the most likely to challenge the Chinese based on the form of the prelims and the semi-final. He's in fourth position going into the final round.
Another good dive. He's been really consistent across the preliminaries, the semis, and the final as well. But put under a lot of pressure today as well. The diving, the standard has just been incredibly high.
Well, he had one dive, his first dive, down in the mid 70s. And ultimately, that is going to be what costs him a medal, because he's finished with an 86.4. And it puts him in second position right now, but with the two divers from China still to come, he is going to be pushed down into fourth place. It's been a terrific effort over three sessions, but ultimately it will be a fourth place finish, you feel, for Bondar.
And the next dive up is the 4.1 degree difficulty. Didn't do so well in the semi-finals. Needs to nail it in the finals.
Forward 4.5 somersaults from Yang Jian. The ability of the Chinese divers to perform when they most need it has been extraordinary.
Fantastic diving from him, and with a 4.1 degree difficulty. That was so much better than it was in the semis.
Well, take out the calculator for this one and add some zeros, because we wait for it, but you wonder where they can potentially take marks away.
Brave to go for a 4.1 in Olympic Games, and you can see how pleased he was with that. They know when they hit the water how good it is.
112.75. Wow.
And that has put Chao Yan under a lot of pressure for his final dive, which I say only, it's only a 3.6. Back 2.5 somersaults, 2.5 twists, but Matthew Mitchum scored 112.10 to win with this in 2008. It's possible to get it right up there.
2.5 somersaults, 2.5 twists, 5. Chao Yuan, the final dive of the final event at the Tokyo 2020 Games, and the gold and silver come down to this.
Wow. It's sometimes hard to find the words, isn't it? Because the diving has been extraordinary.
Well, Yang Jian has just looked, blown his cheeks out and said, well, what more can I do? What can you do about this? Because, well, where do you rate that one?
Incredible. Absolutely incredible. It has been a privilege and an honour to be watching this final, and I'm sure everybody watching at home will feel the same. Brilliant, absolutely fantastic.
And he's done it. Off. He's done it. It's a 102.6. He has managed to find the gold medal dive with the very final dive, and he has won the competition by just under 2 points. Daley takes bronze, Yang Jian takes silver, and Chao Yuan takes gold and becomes the first diver to win Olympic gold at three separate events. Already a gold in 10 meter synchro in London 2012, a gold in the 3 meter individual in Rio 2016, and now Chao Yuan is the gold medalist in the 10-meter platform at Tokyo 2020.
And the way he coped with that under immense pressure, having seen Yang go with that 4.1. I have so much admiration for all of these divers, but to be able to control it and give that sort of performance in a final, outstanding.
Breathtakingly good is the only way I can describe it. Scores 1, 2, 3, 4, with 5 scores in the hundreds in this final. In the final round itself, from the 12 divers in the final, we did have one dive of 68.4, a couple in the 70s.
And so lovely to see coaches from all the other nations. They love to see excellence as well, and they are in total admiration of these divers from the People's Republic of China.
5 dives in the 80s.
Now taking the strapping off, that extra support that he needed in his confirmation of the final scores.
Chao Yuan is the gold medalist in the men's 10-meter platform, 582.35, from his compatriot Yang Jian at 580.40. Tom Daley takes the bronze, 548.25. He adds it to the gold from the 10-meter platform synchro, along with Maddie Lee earlier on at the Games. And his bronze medals, of course, from 2012 and 2016, all the way down. They provided entertainment and quality, not the consistency of quality of Chao Yuan, the gold medalist, or indeed of Yang Jian or Tom Daley, who delivered round after round after round. But all the divers in this final did something special.
Time for a selfie. always got to have the selfie.
I think Yang Jian is extremely disappointed with his silver medal when you consider he put in a dive of 112.75, the score of his final dive, which meant that Chao Yuan had to score 100 plus in order to take the gold medal.
Yeah, put him under so much pressure, but he completely delivered. China yet again taking the gold and the silver.
Yeah, eight events at this diving competition, the program at Tokyo 2020, and of the eight gold medals on offer across synchro and individual, China taken seven of the eight, Great Britain the other, between Daley and Lee in the 10 meter synchro for men. But the Chinese divers utterly dominant, and this is the story of the final of the men's 10 meter platform. It was an event of the highest quality from start to finish. All contributed in the end. The three that took the medals contributed by scoring so highly and so effectively all the way through their six dives, and it was compelling to watch from start to finish. We began with 29 in session three. We reduced to 18 in session two. And for the final session three, we were down to those 12 men. Well, Tom Daley in the third round put in a slight glitch of an 80 plus point score. It dropped him from first to third. And then he went to his sixth round dive, knowing he needed something really special to put pressure on the Chinese. And he did. A 91.8 for his sixth and final dive. It was good enough, we knew, to secure a medal. What we didn't know was it good enough for gold, silver or bronze. Up next came the Chinese Yang Jian, as Daley celebrated, knowing he had at least one more medal to add to his gold from the synchro. We went to Yang Jian, the 4.5 somersaults in the pike position, a degree of difficulty of 4.1. He'd had his troubles with it, but not this time. It had them on their feet at the Tokyo Aquatic Center. And when the scores came through, it was a remarkable 112.75 from Yang Jian. And we thought that might be the gold medal right there. He couldn't give it any more. It meant that his compatriot, Chao Yuan, who had the final dive in the sixth round, had to score in excess of 100 to win gold. Surely he couldn't. Well, Yang Jian knew and applauded what was an outstanding dive, but would it be good enough? Well, the drama. We waited and we wondered, and in the end we knew. 102.6 gold for Chao Yuan and China in what was a magnificent competition that was genuinely a privilege to witness. Disappointment for Yang Jian. I don't think he could believe it. 112.75 in the final round, not good enough for gold. It was good enough for silver. Chao Yuan, the gold medalist. Tom Daley, an excellent bronze. Alexander Bondar, a bit of a distance back in fourth, followed by Minibayev, the 15-year-old from Ukraine. Sareda took sixth, the 14-year-old from Japan. Tamai was seventh. Both those young men, so much promise for Olympics future. Cassie Russo in eighth, and then Jordan Windle, Pereira, and after Pereira came Lochebo and Tudon.
Really nice to see these athlete moments. So the people at home can click on a QR code and see these wonderful athletes and feel that they're part of it. It must be so, so difficult for them, having not been able to attend, watching from afar, supporting from afar, and able to congratulate them afterwards on these screens. A really lovely idea. And this young man, 37th in the World Championships just 2 years ago, and now making it through to the Olympic final.
And finishing 10th. What an improvement. And so many will have stories to tell of the final that they were in, Tokyo 2020. The pictures that tell the story of a final that had everything. Quality and drama aplenty as we round out the diving program at Tokyo 2020, and what a fitting way for it all to finish. So then, we are ready to go with the men's 10-meter platform victory ceremony. Andrea, a competition of the highest quality.
It absolutely was. It totally delivered, didn't it, Ryle? I mean, we cannot begin to even talk about just how incredible those dives were from beginning to end. They totally delivered.
And the ability for these men to deliver the greatest moment, the biggest moment of their careers, an Olympic final, that level of quality under that kind of pressure and scrutiny when everyone went high, well, those that followed seemed to go higher on the scorecard. And Tom Daley, well, he was first after three rounds. But the Chinese athletes absolutely relentless in their pursuit of perfection in the rounds thereafter. He had a little bit of a wobble daily in round four, a wobble as an 80.5. But that was the difference really between him being competitive for gold and having to settle for bronze. But it was a well-earned, hard-earned bronze medal to go alongside his 10-meter synchro gold from earlier on in the week. The honourable members of FINA here to take part in the official ceremony and the presentation of the medals. As the curtain comes down on the diving program at the Tokyo Aquatic Center.
What an incredible moment for Tom Daley. He took the bronze back in London in 2012. He didn't even qualify for the final in 2016. But it's a different story in Tokyo, taking the bronze yet again to add to the gold medal that he won in the synchronized events with Matty Lee. Incredible moments from him and some fantastic diving.
27 years of age now. He's been under significant scrutiny and in the public eye for so long. He walks away with a gold and a bronze. Yang Jian will take silver, and he will look back at a dive in the sixth round that delivered a score of 112.75. He was the one to execute a degree of difficulty of over four. The only diver in the entire program of events in either individual or synchro that went with a degree of difficulty over four. It delivered. He delivered in the sixth round, but it was agonizingly close to gold, but not to be, because of the brilliance of the man who will be announced next. Chao Yuan is the Olympic champion. He stood at the edge of the 10-meter platform knowing he needed to score around 100 points in his final dive to win a gold medal. He stood up and delivered a score of 102.6 to win the gold medal by just short of 2 points.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the People's Republic of China.
皆様、中華人民共和国国歌の演奏です。
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés olympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
The medals and memories of the men's 10-meter platform final.
Stunning medals that they will treasure for a lifetime. Beautifully designed, made from recycled electronic devices. And a stunning moment for them. Now they'll have to go and have lots of photographs taken. They'll go to what we call the mix zone area for all the interviews. And then finally, they will be able to go back and celebrate With their coaches and all the support team, it takes an awful lot of people behind the scenes for these athletes to be able to stand up there and celebrate their medals.
Making sure that the bouquets match the medals, I think, in terms of the colour around each one.
Yeah, that was funny. At least they didn't get the medals round the wrong way. And the bouquet is lovely. And the mascot in there, the mascot standing for Mira Tower, meaning Mira the future, Tower the eternity. And when you look at it with a 14, 15-year-old, 19-year-old, the future is certainly bright for Olympic diving.
Well, there is no doubt. We've seen it across all competitions in both genders. There has been those like Daley who have come with the experience and delivered. There have been those who have come in the very beginning of their careers, in some cases their very first major world event, and they've made it to Olympic finals as young as 13 and 14 years of age, and they are the next generation through, you would think, 2-3 Olympiads where they become the next Tom Daley's. And they are the ones that carry and set the standards for the next group coming through. It's the end of another of the aquatic sports at the Tokyo Aquatic Centre. The swimming program done, the diving program now done, the artistic swimming final to come later on this evening, and that will be that from this magnificent venue. It's been a privilege to be here.
It has been a complete privilege. As we look at the photographs being taken of Tom Daley taking the bronze here, but winning lots of hearts across the globe, especially with all of his superb knitting that he's been doing here. The jumpers that he's come up with have been totally worth a gold medal in their own right.
The standard bearers, you could see, because it's so rare to see emotion in competition from the Chinese athletes, but when Yang Jian hit the water with that 112.75, the display of emotion of being able to nail that dive under the most intense pressure in an Olympic final, well, it was there for all to see. And also the emotion of disappointment when his compatriot Chao Yuan was able to deliver the 100 he required to win the gold medal.
It was all so close, wasn't it? It really was. And how appropriate this music is at the moment. We are the champions. And after all their hard work, to finally know that they are gold, silver, bronze medalists at the Olympic Games in Tokyo, they will wake up tomorrow. And I hope they give themselves some time off to really enjoy the moment, because it takes an awful lot of hard work to get here, and now they need to enjoy it, celebrate it, before they start thinking of competing again if they do decide to carry on for the World Championships next year, also taking place in Japan.
Bank of photographers, one of two or three pods of photographers around this aquatic center. They walk maybe 100 meters and stop in front of the next group for the next set of photographs that will grace the newspapers and websites and magazines of the world aquatic press and the sports pages, and indeed beyond that. And Zhao and Yang will come down those steps. They turn right and head down in front of the reporters that are assembled for some of the major broadcasters around the world.
And it was so lovely to see all the other coaches from the other nations going up and congratulating these two, because they know what it takes, how hard it is to be able to achieve the standard of diving that we have seen today.
Okay. So that's a wrap from the Tokyo Aquatic Center and what has been a compelling and engaging final day, a compelling and engaging program of 8 diving events, 4 in synchro, 4 in individual, 2 in each gender, and we're left with magnificent memories. Well, the slow motion images diving at the Olympic Games always stand with the most memorable images of sporting events from the entire Games. You think of the start of the 8s in rowing and canoeing as well, and the start of the triathlon. So many events conjure up such great images at an Olympic Games, and no more so than the diving and the slow motion shots we've seen from this magnificent venue. It has been a privilege, it has been a pleasure, and it is the end of the diving program at the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games.